you know Patrice O'Neal?
I did.
Can you share a story about him if you can? Because that's my favorite comedian of all time. Keeping it real.
Dude, Patrice O'Neal was, he was way deeper off stage. Funny, a goddamn fool, but bruh, would hold court and crack niggas head open with game. Patrice had game like a motherfucker. Patrice is one of them. Patrice was cut out of the same shit Biggie was. He just did comedy.
You can tell by his stand-up that he's spitting game, but he's doing it in a funny way. But everything he say on stage is basically facts.
No, sure. See, I listen to hours of Patrice off the stage when he's
Opie and Anthony.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, hours. And that dude was funny.
A no fucking what guru. The fuck he was talking about. It didn't matter what you was talking about. And not Patrice was didn't have a funny formula. He didn't have a funny formula. He didn't play a certain set of funny notes. That nigga was a jazz artist.
One of my favorite comments, Craig Robinson. What you guys think about him?
Craig and I, that's funny you should mention him. We were in a band together. The band was all comedians. It was me, Craig Robinson, brother out of the Bay, bass player, Will Walls, rest in peace to Bobby Law, funny motherfucker, hell of a guitarist. We could all play, and we were all funny. The name of the band was 5150.
Mm. You on the drums.
Yeah.
Craig on the keyboard.
Craig on the keys.
Okay. We got Bobby Long on the guitar.
On the guitar, and my boy Will Walls on the bass, and we was funky as your grandpa's feet, nigga.
I bet.
It was really a hot, it was a hot thing. We were really focused on it. We were about to start shopping it, and Craig got the office. Craig is my brother. Mm-hmm. I love Craig Robinson. Nigga, me and Craig go back like rocking chairs. And please understand, for those of you who may get it twisted, Craig Robinson is a gangster that come from gangsters. Nigga, it's no joke.
Who was that comedian that Jamie Foxx body? What was his name?
Doug Williams.
Oh, yeah, Doug Williams, that's my man.
I think Doug Williams is funny.
Everybody have an off night, but going against Jamie Foxx.
No, that's not fair to say.
Jamie Foxx is not.
Hold on, Meats. Give us the gag, Jeff. What was you finna say, Jeff?
That's not fair to say. Fox did what
they edited. They edited the shit.
No.
All right, right.
This is just grown man to grown man. Dude never should have had that gig.
I've heard that too.
He shouldn't have had that gig. And that's not a knock at Doug. It's just that nobody knew who he was.
Right.
He would have had to do Tony Roberts style comedy about those people to where it became so much about the character that it wasn't about what he was saying because no one knew who the fuck he was. It was like he was some guy out of the audience.
Right.
So when it got awkward because people were looking at him because you don't get no runway, motherfucker. We don't know you.
Right.
When it got awkward, Jamie obeyed the number one rule in comedy. Do not deny the obvious.
Get him.
And he was just chumming the fucking water. He was chumming the water. And I felt bad for him, but I also, that shit that Fox did was fucking hilarious. Let me tell you why that didn't hurt Doug Williams' career at all. Doug Williams is the executive producer of First Amendment stand-up.
I was just going to say that. I remember the brother hosting it. He was
and the nigga is hilarious.
I agree with that.
I love people that can dish it out and can also take it.
I'm going to tell you something else about Doug and why he is that way. Because Doug is grounded outside of this shit. Doug is a family man with a wife and kids.
Right.
Here, Doug is a goddamn grown-ass man. When you get to that point,